Hi everyone, it's Gus from Pie My Life Up, and today I'll be taking you through the steps of setting up Uptime Kuma on the Raspberry Pi. Uptime Kuma is a free and open source uptime monitoring tool. Using this software, you can measure the uptime and response time of various services. You can monitor a range of different services and protocols such as HTTPS, HTTP, TCP, ping, DNS records, Steam game servers, Docker containers, and more. If an issue is detected, Uptime Kuma can send a notification to various services. These services include Discord, Telegram, Slack, and many more. To get started, either open the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or SSH to it. First, update the package list by entering sudo apt update. Now upgrade any out-of-date packages by entering sudo apt upgrade-y. You will need to have Docker installed to your Raspberry Pi in order to complete this tutorial. I will link a tutorial in the description on how you can install Docker to the Raspberry Pi. If you are unsure if you have Docker installed, simply enter docker-v. If Docker is installed, you should see a version number. Once you are certain Docker is installed, it's time to create a directory. This directory will store our Uptime Kuma compose files. You can do this by entering sudo mkdir-p /opt/stacks/uptime-kuma. The -p ensures that all the directories will be created if they are missing. Now change into the directory by entering cd/opt/stacks/uptime-kuma. We will now want to make sure wget is installed. To ensure it is installed, simply enter sudo apt install wget. In my case, you can see that it is already installed. Now let's fetch the Uptime Kuma compose file from our git by entering sudo wget https://git.pymylifeup.com/compose/uptime-kuma-pi/compose.yaml. Now open the file by entering sudo nano compose.yaml. In here, we define the Uptime Kuma service and set the image to point to the latest version of the Uptime Kuma software. Next, we define two different volumes. The first volume will map the external data /opt/stacks/uptime-kuma/data directory to the internal app/data directory. The second volume will allow Uptime Kuma access to the docker.sock file. This will allow Uptime Kuma to monitor other Docker services. The port configuration will map the external port 3001 to the internal port 3001. You can change the external port if required, however, do not change the internal port. Lastly, Docker will restart the service if it crashes or stops responding. If you manually stop the service, it will not automatically restart. Once you're happy with the file, press Ctrl X to exit. Once you're ready to start the Uptime Kuma Docker container, run the following command: docker compose up-d. Lastly, we will need to grab the IP address of the Raspberry Pi. To do this, enter hostname hyphen capital I. Our IP address is the first one in the list. To go to our newly created Uptime Kuma instance, open your favorite web browser and enter the IP address followed by a colon and the port 3001. In my case, it is 192.168.0.15:3001. You'll be greeted with a sign up screen. Fill out the relevant fields such as your username and password. Once you're happy with everything, click create. You can now see the dashboard of the Uptime Kuma software. Since we do not have any monitors, it will look a bit bare at the moment. So let's create our first monitor by clicking add new monitor. In here, you will find a wide range of settings. For this example, we will keep it basic. Keep the monitor type as HTTPS. I will set the friendly name to Pi My Life Up. This is the name you'll see in the dashboard. I will monitor the Pi My Life Up website. So for the URL, I will enter https://pimylifeup.com. There are plenty of other settings within this interface. For example, you can set up a notification service with a range of different providers. You can configure how often to check the service. For example, the default is every 60 seconds. You can also set the time before it considers a service down. For example, the default is 48 seconds. You can also change the accepted status code. The default status code is 200 to 299. Once you're happy with everything, simply click Save. As you can see, the software will now start monitoring Pi My Life Up. There are plenty of other settings you can change. You can find these by clicking the profile icon in the top right corner. In the drop-down, click Setting. I recommend going through these settings to ensure that everything is set up how you want. If you ever need to update Uptime Kuma, simply go back to the terminal. In the terminal, change the directory so that you are within the directory holding the compose file. So cd /opt/stacks/uptimekuma. Enter docker compose pool to grab the latest available version. Once that is done, simply enter docker compose up-d and Docker will now restart the service using the latest version. I hope you now have Uptime Kuma up and running on your Raspberry Pi. If you have enjoyed this tutorial and would love to see more, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.